Are you serious? Are you serious? Guys, get a cup of coffee and calm down. But Tropical Storm Alberto has arrived. He's in the Gulf of Mexico, and he's headed for the Gulf. Matter of fact, Mississippi and Florida have already declared state of emergencies. Before I get any further, I'll give you the full details on what's happening here. I want to put a shout-out. I promised I would for 5 days. A shout-out to NobleGoldInvestments.com. Colin Plume is waiting right now to help anybody that wants to know what to do with their 401k or their IRA. You may want to diversify. They are the experts. Remember, they're a Christian company, a family-owned business, and they really, really treat people right and with great integrity. And so I can tell you, they're good friends of our ministry, and we really appreciate what they do for people. So check it out. That's NobleGoldInvestments.com. All right, here's the situation right now. The Alberto is the first tropical storm of the year, and it's not even June 1st, but it's begun. The center of Alberto is now reformed. It has reorganized. You guys may remember, I've been talking about this for 5 days. I've been way out ahead of the media, and you guys know this already. And what I was concerned about, because I looked at the aerial view, I looked at the satellite view, and I could see the swirl beginning. Well, the center of Alberto has now reformed. It's in the southern Gulf of Mexico. Alberto will strengthen, will move very slowly toward the northern Gulf coast late this weekend. And landfall of Alberto along the northern Gulf coast is expected late Monday night or early Tuesday morning. Now, because Alberto's going slow, it's gathering energy and lots of moisture. And it's going to dump that rain somewhere, folks. The main concern will be heavy rain over parts of Cuba, which is exactly what I predicted, Florida, southern Florida, just as I predicted in the southeast. And they've already hit Belize. Now, flash flooding and river flooding may become more widespread and last well into the next week because it's stalling. This is a lot like Harvey, but not as big. The tropical storm winds and storm surge flooding are likely from Louisiana to Florida, the entire panhandle, Mississippi, Louisiana, Alabama, and Florida. Texas, you're going to be okay. Also, there could be some tornadoes expected to break loose and also very powerful rip currents. Stay out of the water. And I know it's Memorial Day weekend, but stay out of the water, folks. Subtropical storm Alberto is now shifting into the Gulf of Mexico. We'll head toward the northern Gulf coast in the Memorial Day weekend, bringing the threat of flash flooding, rip currents, strong winds, coastal flooding, tornadoes, and of course, power outages. New tropical storm warnings have been issued for Florida's west coast and parts of northern Gulf of Mexico. Alberto is the first named storm of the year, and we're not even on June 1st. Matter of fact, the National Weather Service is predicting 13 hurricanes this year in the Atlantic Ocean, and that's a lot. And so we've got to really watch it. This could be a bad year. Now, last year we suffered through Hurricane Harvey, Hurricane Irma, and Hurricane Maria. Horrendous damage in Houston, Texas, and Florida, and of course, Puerto Rico was about destroyed. Now, its appearance on satellite probably doesn't resemble most named storms that you've seen in hurricane season before, but Alberto's thunderstorms have blown to the east of the surface low pressure center from above level westerly winds. Dry air is also impinging on Alberto from the west and had been taking some toll on the thunderstorms near the surface low. However, it now appears the thunderstorms are beginning to cluster closer to the center. It's reorganizing. And this is a necessary condition for future strengthening. The water is warm in the Gulf of Mexico, and so it will gather energy. Alberto is currently a tropical storm, basically a hybrid between a tropical storm and a warm core, okay? But it's packing a pretty good punch and a lot of water. And despite all these clusters of thunderstorms, With heavy rain now pushing through the western two-thirds of Cuba, some heavier rain has already overspread South Florida. And Alberto should continue moving north, then curl toward the north-northwest, gaining some strength over the next few days. As lift from upper atmosphere gives a boost to the thunderstorms near the center. And a building dome of high pressure. What? Over the upper Midwest, responsible for the holiday weekend heat. It is hot here in Indiana. It was 96 degrees yesterday. What? Well, this I'm concerned that as this comes forward, of course, the hot air is going to hit the cool, and that can spin off some tornadoes. Also, the water temperatures over the northern Gulf of Mexico are sufficiently warm. Matter of fact, they're warmer than average for this time of year in May. While we can't rule out, or Alberto could end up being a Category 1 hurricane, we hope it stays no more than a tropical storm. You can find more about the history of hurricanes, of course, if you study it on the internet. But as you looked at the thumbnail that I put out earlier, it shows you the path of the storm. Expected to be about 65 to 70 mile-an-hour winds as it comes ashore. It should be very strong. It really could cause a lot of problems. The rain is going to be more effective than even the storm surge or the wind. But still, guys, this could end up being a Category 1 because of the warmth of the Gulf of Mexico. I'll be back with more current world events, how they relate to biblical prophecy. There is a scripture in the Bible. Jesus said in Luke 21, verse 25, he said, "For there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars and distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring. Men's hearts would fail them for fear, for looking after those things that are coming upon the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken." So the sea and the waves roaring and the heavens shaking, and look at the volcano quaking and the lava is flowing, and the situation in Hawaii is really, really dangerous. We're going to keep a close eye on all of this throughout the weekend. Stay with me. We'll be on top of all the current world events. Now, some good news. President Trump was able to get that young man and his wife out of Venezuela. They were stuck in a Venezuela jail for 2 years on charges that were totally bogus. They were framed and were rotting in prison. And President Donald Trump was able to get them released. They will be at the White House, I understand, in about an hour. And this is big news. Bob Corker actually was part of the team that went down to get them out. The president organized it from the White House, and the deal is done. So, you got to give President Trump some credit. He got the three people out of North Korea, and now he got these two out of Venezuela. And meanwhile, the summit with North Korea is back on for June 12th. So there's a lot going on. Let's keep an eye on all of it, all right? We're truly living in the last days. Give your life to Jesus Christ. Something biblical's going on with the signs of the second coming of Christ. Are you saved?